Smart cities probably means different things to different people. To me, it's kind of a software layer, I would say, that can be added to our cities.
We're trying to understand how drivers travel around the city and how their behavior might be correlated to crashes. To do that, we actually were able to get data from New York City's entire vehicle fleet. And what we're looking for is anomalies, basically, in driver behavior. In this case, you're starting to understand the flow of all these vehicles through an entire city network. So that really opens up a whole new way of looking at our infrastructure.
As engineers in general, we're used to using data to tell us how things are working in the real world. So we started instrumenting green roofs to understand how they can actually contribute to the environmental sustainability of urban environments. In addition to monitoring infrastructure performance, we now need to start thinking about humans in the loop. We're very interested in what could motivate people to reduce their energy consumption.
So at the Sustainable Engineering Lab, we're really interested in the dynamics between how people consume energy and how it's produced on the grid, which is what's happening not just in each building, but in each apartment, and really just each device turning on and off. And if we can understand how they're consuming energy at the massive scale, then we can change things at that atomic level and hopefully change the way that we demand energy so that it really follows the supply of wind and solar.
What we have created here is a wearable app. And what this can show is what we call energy footprint, or your personalized, individualized energy usage. In addition, the system computes what actions that you could take to reduce energy. If you, let's say, go to work 10 minutes earlier, you would be able to save 5 pounds of coal.
So if you look around in the cities, there's so much carbon out there, including construction materials. So instead of looking at just existing technology, can we redesign the entire system so that there's a zero emission? Why not? So we are looking at how to reclaim waste concrete and then make new materials out of it. Can we embed sensors within the construction materials to understand how our buildings behave so that we can make the overall cities more sustainable?
So we are building a testbed that covers 1 square mile in West Harlem to look at next generation wireless technologies at a city scale. You can think about it as an outdoor lab that will provide connectivity in this large area and be able to send a lot of data and to receive a lot of data. The idea is to push the state of the art in wireless communication and wireless networking.
This is a tide gauge station here that the Coast Guard runs, and we use it for testing out whether our code or our model actually matches what really happened in Hurricane Sandy. Being able to forecast a storm surge is kind of amazing. You look at the complexity around here. From a city perspective, you want to be able to smartly protect yourself. You want to find optimal ways to do so. This overlaps with being smarter about the electrical grid, trying to figure out ways to react to disasters or help with the subway system in a smart way.
This would involve sealing all the entrances, sealing all the ventilation openings in between. The solution is not only for the subway system, it's for the entire infrastructure, buildings, bridges, underground infrastructure, above ground infrastructure, in the entire metropolitan area, because this type of a solution cannot be local. We have to think about this globally.
We know as a society we're moving towards a planet where 70% of the population is going to live in an urban environment. So the sustainability of those environments is actually important to the future of our planet. Many people around the world look to what's happening in New York City as an example of what could happen elsewhere. I think it's a natural fit.